What bad habit has affected you the most in life?
What bad habit has affected me the most in life? I'll have to think.
Bad habits.
In life.
Bad habit.
What bad habit? Stealing.
Smoking. I'll say smoking. Nicotine.
Procrastination.
I'll say procrastination.
Procrastination is one of them.
Say drinking.
Yeah.
Drinking because, you know, I used to drink a lot and then I got really sick. You know, do surgery like twice last year. So I would say that is like a major bad habit. And then I obviously stopped, you know, so yeah.
Overthinking?
Yes, overthinking.
Stubbornness. I'm stubborn. I don't let things go. I get what I want. So I think that helps as a force to get things done. There are times where people would want to like push you over. Maybe based on being a woman for one, you have to be stubborn.
Overthinking is a bad habit that's affected me most. Because you can tell me one thing and my brain can give like 10 different interpretations of that thing, and sometimes it's just not nice most of the time.
I think you spend a lot of time in your head thinking about the structure of things and how they could be, or how you could, you know, do them better, where you might as well just go out and do them. And you know, this affects you in every area of your life.
Like if my mom calls me more than once, because she barely calls, so if she calls me more than once, my brain starts thinking, what have you done now? What did they find in your room? Who called them, you know? And then at the end of the day, she just wanted to see how I was doing.
Well, it's something I worked on, but yeah, I used to procrastinate a lot.
I mean, it's kept me from doing things when they needed to be done in terms of work, you know, especially with the, for both of them, we are also a social media marketing aspect. When you get a client and you're supposed to talk to the client, but sometimes you get carried away and you don't, and the client already seemed interested in the conversation. But then when you get carried away and then you're having a conversation like the next 2-3 days, either he's already moved on or just not as interested or, you know, excited about the whole conversation again.
I would say maybe memorizing. Yeah, I think. Because that takes a lot of money from you. Like for example, you meet a lady and then you have small talk. Then you plan events, maybe dates, hang out. And Nigeria now, it's very, like everything is just, it's about money. Like if you're meeting a girl, like for instance now, she wants to come to you, most times you have to pay for Uber. Not all the time, but most of the time you have to pay for Uber. You have to look for where to hang out, you pay for food and stuff. And some girls, they feel entitled that, okay, if you guys are hanging out, they should be able to send them money and, you know, things like that. So that takes a lot of money because that's like a new norm for people now. So
not checking up on people.
Poor communication.
I feel like sometimes I always forget to, you know, check up on the ones that I do love, and somehow they take it, you know, the other way. But I mean, sure, I still love them. It's just that, you know, I hardly do that.
Because most of the times I get this kind of, what I call it, anxiety about like picking up the phone and calling people. I feel awkward about answering calls or even texting back.
So many times I do have, I'm in a situation where, you know, I really need something, right, from people that I'm close to. But because, you know, maybe for a while, because we're not, you know, connecting at all.
I've lost quite a few friends because of that, because they end up thinking, especially new friends, if I make new friends, and I end up not communicating with them subsequently. They end up thinking I'm a snob or I'm a fake person because, you know, we had fun and then I didn't communicate, so.
Being a perfectionist, for some people, I think most people cannot just understand why I'm a perfectionist or why, you know, I would want some certain things to be done perfectly.
I think slouching. I'm not sure. Maybe slouching.
I said chewing my fingers. Although I'm trying to grow them now. And it's been a beautiful journey.
Started from stealing from my mother and stuff like that. But with time, I stopped this crush in school, as at that time, secondary school crush. So it was his birthday and I wanted to get him something for his birthday. I was getting my crush something for his birthday now. So my mom used to sell fish, fried fish and all. So I stole from her to buy massets and storybook for my crush.
Wasting money on internet. So I've actually taken a loan before to buy data and I used to download a video game.
I don't have a lot of bad habits and I don't know if this has affected me a lot negatively or positively, but I eat a lot of food.
Gambling. Back in the days I used to be a gambler. I've gambled with a lot of things, money, clothes, shoes, wristwatch, jewelry.
People think I don't have food in my house. I'm hungry. I'm suffering. So when they see me eat food, they're like, ah, this guy's probably not eating for 2 days. But no, I probably ate like 2 hours ago.
Sugar. I have a sweet tooth, but it's kind of scattered my teeth at some point when I was growing up. I think it's sugar.
The only bad habit I have is like maybe talking too much. Talking too much and make people to misunderstand me.
Laughing at serious issues. I mean, I almost died the other day and I was laughing.